Used to do lots of community work. I was involved with many other organizations and helping poor people, our community people, to teach language, etc. And one organization we had where my husband was very much involved, that was based in Glasgow, called Asian Artists Association. That was the very first art organization where Dr. Prashad was the chair. And Mr. Kohli, S.S. Kohli, I'm sure you heard the name, he was the secretary and I was the treasurer. So we connected that, and that was the only one organization where we used to try to teach language, Hindi language, dance, songs, music. And through Asian Artists Association, I think through the SAC, in networking with the SAC, Scottish Asian Action Committee, we had the first Asian Mela in Glasgow. That was the first in Scotland. And then that was the first year. The second year, Asian artists took it over, and Asian artists, you know, arranged this whole program for years and years. It was in the tramway. And that was quite full. And as you know, that that time, our population, or even Scottish population, was not that great, actually. And that was more than enough space we had. Second year, we found that people can't come inside the tramway because of, you know, the hall completely full. So then we changed from there to the Kelvin Grove Park. But I remember that still, those days, Mela used to be not one day. One day, because of funding situation, became one day, used to go for 7 days or something like that. And team from India, team from Bangladesh, team from Pakistan, all musicians used to come. My husband wanted to start Durga Puja. I must say this, that started from 1981. My husband, who initiated that, our children are, first generation was limited. I'm talking about Bengali generation in Scotland. Very, very limited number. You could count in your finger. And so our children are, if we are staying in this country permanently, then our children should know their root, which is very important for each and every family, actually. So that came in his mind, that our Bengali religion, we said Durga Puja is our main festival, really social religious, you can say. And so 1981 he initiated with his friends, and that was the very first festival, religious festival in Scotland, for whole of Scotland. But after my husband's death, I had all these really, really good friends like Dr. Malcolm Green, Mr. Kohli, Dr. Prashad, and of course, Bashir Maan, things. They said, no, Sheila. I was very, at that one stage away, I was very depressed, and I didn't know, I was young, I was not even 50. I didn't know what to do, what I will do now. And my family from India, they asked me, come back. Come back here. Why you are going to struggle there? You have to work, you have to do. But I thought, my both sons are in the private school. And if I go, their life will be changed. Whatever it is, even if you have money in India, you can buy everything. But I thought, no, they're more born and brought up here. They have seen from their childhood different world, actually. I don't want to go back. I want to stay with them here. So then CRE, Strathclyde Community Relations Council, one post was vacant, and somebody asked me, you apply. I said, it's too quick. Within a month, I can't do anything. My husband passed away just now. I can't think of anything. I didn't know anything, what to do. I was so confused. My life was completely in dark. But somehow, then I thought, no, I have to stand on my feet. How would I do? Money is not a problem. My both son can continue the private school, but I have to stand. I have to be with them. So then that job came out, and I definitely applied, and luckily I got the job as a community relations officer under the Strathclyde Community Relations Council, where Bashir Maan was the chairperson. For the ethnic minority carers group, I established that, was initiated by our Strathclyde Community Relations Council, and I worked as a project manager for that, actually. So before that, our ethnic minority group, and by then, a lot of ethnic minority were in Strathclyde region, mainly based in Glasgow, south side of Glasgow. And also, work on disability, I did that. We knew that for some reason, in Muslim family have more disabled children, which we did a big survey also under that council. And then we came to know that many families have not only one disabled, two, three disabled children, mostly Muslim families. So from very scratch, we started to survey that. No, without knowing any name, without knowing any address, without knowing any family, we literally went to Southside. We used to go to Southside, knocking the door, looking that, knowing that all these our ethnic minority people are around here, actually. We found out, and we had a big survey on that. And that was the very first survey under our satellite Community Relations Council, and we started to work with disabled people and also ethnic minority carers, because always I love community, always I like to meet people, and I did really my life dedicated for the community, and that was my passion. And lucky, definitely I believe in God, and definitely God's blessings I had, family blessings I had, and I had good friends around me. Indian British, definitely I'll say, or Scottish, but my heart is still, as you grow older and older, probably is a very natural thing when you think about your own country. It doesn't matter, I'm saying, you know, this is my country, Britain is my country, but still there is a weak point somewhere when I have that India, where I was, you know, born, I was grow up, I had my all education, I got married, and then I came over here, though it's not, you know, and I spend more time here now. But still, the soft corner is there now, definitely. Integration is very good. From my work, I could see when limited number of our ethnic minority around here in Scotland, people always said integrate, integrate, integrate. But at that point, immediately you can't integrate everything, segregate, because when two different people, two different language, two different culture, you are bringing together, it will take time to establish. But now I think time is already over now, but now people can't say that we don't know English language, you have to give me extra facility, extra benefit, this. I don't believe in that. I think the people who have come, you know, and who know the culture of this country, who know the benefits of this country, who know what we can do, we should work together. And now integration is the time when we all working together. Like, this is the time when working together, if you say, as I mentioned, the second, third generation, they don't think they are different from local white people, actually. What's that mean? That means we all are one.